Minimum wage workers will be ringing in the new year with a little extra cash in their wallets. Starting tomorrow, that $8 an hour paycheck will increase to $8.75.
You know, you can't really live off of $8 an hour. I'm not even sure you can live off of $8.75 an hour.
And while many business owners oppose the hike, Adam Gold, the owner of Funkin' Waffles, says he's pleased New York is finally stepping up and raising the minimum wages.
I was aware of this for a while now, so I've been trying to get, you know, several of my employees like already close to that mark, if they're not already there. I think it's a good thing.
To get perspective from someone who helps those workers get on their feet, we sat down with Executive Director of CNY Works, Lenore Seely. She tells me she can see both the benefits and the drawbacks when it comes to increasing wages.
It's awfully hard to feed a family on that if you're the only wage earner, okay? On the other hand, we want the economy to thrive, and employers' biggest source of expenditures is their labor, the cost of labor.
New hires in the new year will see the benefit immediately, and the hikes won't stop there.
Now, in addition to that, minimum wage workers can actually be expecting $9 per hour by the end of 2015.
But keep in mind, that depends on your position.
If you're a bartender, your minimum wage is $5. You know, obviously tips will equal, hopefully, at least minimum wage or more. But if a tips employee doesn't make $8.75 with their tips, then they automatically get that minimum wage.
Adding a little more money to the pockets of those who work hard for every cent they get. Reporting in Syracuse, I'm Sarahbeth Ackerman.